We are coming to you live from
our bed. Yeah, yeah. The best place to have pillow talk. Right?
Yeah. I'm the missus.
I'm Mr.
And we are going to discuss quite the conversations.
In the bedroom. The best place to have the best conversations before you go to bed.
Yeah, because nobody gossips more than a husband and wife telling each other about the day they've had. Right before they get ready to go to bed.
Pretty much. Especially if the communication is open. That is probably the, because then you're talking about the kids, in the day off work.
Yeah, all of the craziness included in between.
Yeah. So, no topic is...
just a soft introduction.
Yeah, but I'm just saying, no topic off limits, right?
No.
No topic off limits. Yeah.
I think we feed off a controversial topic, so...
You think?
Yeah. Because I think we still have a difference of opinions on a lot of things. So I think it's going to be a quite interesting podcast.
Yeah. I believe so.
Well, we hope so. Mm. If not, then we'll just listen to ourselves. Yeah, that'll pretty much be it. I am a mother of two girls. I work in healthcare and... I met the mister here about 2 years ago.
Actually, it is not.
Well, we officially became official about 2 years ago.
Yeah. Because.
We're doing introductions, Hurt. You have to introduce yourself first. So I just did my introduction, sweetie.
Okay. Well, I'm the mister, and I am a father of five.
Ooh, Lord, that's a lot of chillums.
Whatever. And two girls and three boys. Unfortunately, I've obtained all five of those throughout separate relationships. Unfortunately, didn't want that to happen, but I'm disabled 100%, but I don't live life as a disabled person.
Disabled, don't let him fool y'all.
I am classified as disabled. Whatever. I have multiple sclerosis. And if you don't know what that is, Google it. Yeah, Google it.
Well, we probably will have a topic. We'll take a segment and talk about your MS.
I think
and
we should.
Dating someone with MS.
I think we should, because I think disability in general. Yes. With dating and marrying, because what someone has told you basically,
sure you want to be with somebody who's like disabled?
Yeah, it's like
I don't see you as disabled, so it doesn't. It's just I don't know, but we'll get more into that later.
Yeah, yeah.
So collectively, we have 7 children as of right now that we've described. I haven't even gone into the 3 wonderful step babies that I have from my previous marriage. They're women. They're grown. Love them to death. And mutual love from them as well for their little sisters. And
yeah, I had some, but due to unfortunate circumstances.
He has... She got 2? So you got 2 stepdaughters as well?
Yeah, 2 stepdaughters, and I claim an extra daughter
another stepdaughter from the first relationship.
Yeah. Yeah. So.
Collectively, we count a lot of children.
Yeah, a bunch.
Deal with a lot of teenage and young person issues. So we'll probably have some interesting stories about the children and what they go through and the conversations we have to have with them about life.
Life. I often say just having a conversation with them about life in general.
We're going to discuss parenting. We don't like politics, but I guess we'll get into that too.
Yeah, why not? Politics, church,
religion, spirituality.
Yeah, because what?
As we've gotten over, we've had some very interesting conversations about religion and what we believe.
Yeah, and energy and just.
Yeah.
And I think this, world,
natural order, just everything.
And I really seriously felt the need for us to do something similar to this is due to because we are always being drawn to either events,
weird conversations,
and it deals with relationships and people are talking
to us. 95% of the time thinking the same thing in our head about something we've seen or responded to.
Yeah.
Or we have a difference of opinion on something we've seen or responded to.
But I think it all meshes up very well, though.
Yeah, but I mean, we listen to each other's opinion, though.
Yeah.
At the end of the day.
Yeah, and I don't think we knock each other's opinion.
No.
No.
We can't. I mean, the world is mean. It's too mean to be too stuck on one thing, one way.
Yeah. I guess I can say that, you know, I know a lot of people say that, you know, when they meet a new person, that, you know, this
you're
person
so
different. Well, not even though, you know how they always, you different.
Oh, he's the one.
Yeah. But
he's so perfect for me. Well, what about that person do you really like?
But you are different. Like, seriously, like 100%.
But I mean, to you, I'm different. But to another guy that I've already been with before, like, he may think I'm just an average person, regular girl. Even I say that about myself. I'm just a regular old country girl. Ain't nothing special about me.
But I guess, you know, constantly, again, like I say, the fact that we communicate makes you different. Everyone that I dated, communication was like lack.
I mean, well, I guess that would debunk the theory that women are mainly the communicators where men aren't.
But I'm different, bro.
Again, so you feel like I'm different and I feel like you're different. Like, most of the guys that I have been with, they don't really open up to dialogue or don't really open up to the fact of, well, babe, what you think about? Very few of them have asked me that. And if they did ask me, it's more from a business perspective. You know, it wasn't like just to get my opinion or just to see what I was thinking about something.
Yeah, I've always really been kind of, because I always did my mom like that. You know, I always ask my mom how she feels about something. Not saying I was going to do
what she said,
but I guess it's a sense of, I guess you have a form of respect for a person that you value their opinion.
Yeah.
And I think people, like, don't really, what's the word I'm looking for? That gets misused a lot. The fact that you valuing someone's opinion.
Valuing the opinion versus even hearing out their opinion in the beginning or taking advantage of their opinion.
Yeah, taking advantage of the opinion, you know, and not, you know, so.
Opinion for benefit? Yeah, people do that a lot.
Yeah, maybe that's what I'm trying to say.
Or I'm going to ask you your opinion, but your opinion really don't matter at the end of the day anyway.
Yeah.
Especially if it doesn't make sense to line up with what my opinion is.
Nah, you know, there's a lot of men that feel that way about women.
Why you ask my opinion
and you ain't going to, if I give it to you.
And then still 95% of men feel like that's nagging. If a woman does it, if I say, well, baby, what you think about this? What shoe should I wear, the red one or the blue one?
Yeah, because then when they say red one, then they go put the blue one on anyway.
And, like, you're going to be like, well, why you ask me if you already knew? Well, I just, you know, kind of wanted a difference of opinion.
But I don't see it like that, though.
Nah, most men don't see it like that.
No, I'm saying I don't see it like that.
You,
like,
oh, even would, if I honestly
even,
say,
even if I say red and you put on blue, kind of like today with, you know.
With the shoes.
It just, yeah, that don't bother me.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I really seriously think this because my mom had the most influence.
He's mom's boy.
But not in a mom's boy to where I can't separate myself from my mama.
Well, we're going
to
have a conversation about that too.
Yes, because you have a lot of men that can't separate themselves from their mama. That's and
true. In marriage.
Yeah. And I guess, you know, on a couple of cases of conversation and groups and the things that we was on, some of the men, some of the women.
I'm going to do my mama regardless. And their dad, mommy's.
With the women and the men too, though.
They can't separate self from,
you know.
Self from home as they know. And create their own home, you know. Creating their own dynamic that works.
Yeah, you know, like I've said about, you know, your dad, you know, and I see the level of the bar that he set in your life.
Right.
And it's not that I'm trying to achieve that same bar because I know I can't be him. And it's not my purpose to be him.
No, but I don't want anybody else to be my daddy. I love my daddy to death for who he is, but I don't think I want to relive that on a daily basis in a relationship.
Yeah, I just want to, but I want to bring the
bring you your uniqueness to the relationship.
Yeah, but it's still the,
because if I wanted to be with my daddy, then I go back and be with my daddy. That would be weird.
Like the equalness of that feeling, but not per se your dad. You get what I'm trying to say?
Like I hold you in the same high esteems and respect that I would my daddy, but you're not really my dad.
Yeah,
I respect you as a person enough to say, you know what? You are noble enough, like my father, that I
and I think that's what, and I think that's what people get mixed up with. Cause that's how I see you. I see you as a noble female. Is that I respect you in the form as I respect my mom, and but I don't see you as being my mom, even though you remind me. Mm-hmm. You know,
mannerisms
and stuff. But outside of that, but no, I don't. I don't know. I just think it would be weird, though. You know, sitting up there.
That's what I just said. It just would be awkward.
We doing the do, and then the only thing I can do is seeing my mama looking at me. And yeah, that would be very awkward.
Awkward indeed. I agree.
So.
Yeah, it's still recording. So as long as we're talking, I guess it'll stop when we hit the stop button.
Stop button, yeah. So until you, shit. My bad. Very authentic.
Authentic.
No retakes. No go back and try and we didn't like that. So what you hear is what you get with us. And
we have a Instagram page where we'll ask for some feedback. It's Mr. and Mrs. Take Over the World. All of that is one word. It is Mr. and Mrs. Or is it Miss and Mr.?
Thank you.
So there we'll probably post portions of our podcast, just a little snippet of it, and then we'll also kind of ask for your opinions and ask what topics you'd like to hear us discuss, and we'll share when we will be posting more info convos.
It's Mr. and A-N-D
M-R-A-N-D, M-R-S, take, T-A-K-E, O-V-E-R, T-H-E-W-O-R-L-D.
So,
Mr. and Miss Take Over the World. We think we fly. We think we can handle it. We've been through enough.
Both of us together and with you. Yeah.
By no means we're perfect at all.
Nope. And we're
not experts. We're experienced. And we quoted that from some friends of ours.
Yeah.
So I think it's.
So, and the thing about advice and something that I tell a lot of people is that you do know, you know.
What worked for me may not necessarily work for you.
Yes. And even if you were to hear something or even listen to something that we say that we may try and you try it yourself, you have to understand that once you grab hold to that and you put it in to use with yourself, that actually becomes yours. So don't be coming talking about, Mr. and Mrs. Takeover, they told me to do this, it ain't weird for me, and now I'm homeless and all.
We're not here for that.
Yeah.
We're here to share a common conversation. And again, we're open to whatever topic you want to discuss. Again, we're not experts. We're just a little experienced at it. And we want to share our experience with you.
I don't know about her, but I'm a doctor in relationships because of the stuff that I've put myself through.
He swear he a relationship coach.
Unfortunately.
Unfortunately,
it went on. It might as well say it was on purpose because it was stupidity on my part. A lot of the relationships I've been in. And if you don't.
Hey, how will you know what's right until you get something wrong, you know?
Well, that's what I was going to say. A lot of folks run from they past. And you know what? The best thing is to go and look at your past because it's the only way that you're going to learn.
The future going forward.
Yep.
And how not to make the same mistakes again. Yep. Or how to go forward in the next relationship with a different mindset and perspective. And I think that is truly what has happened here. I don't like this guy though. You know,
oh my God. You know, and we're going to get to a point where I get to tell this story over and over again, where it's going to be on a podcast that everybody in the world can listen to, how she refuses to remember how all of this started. But that's a whole nother story. But I would like to say about
we probably will not have that conversation. Yes, he'll probably will. Be on his own trying to tell that one, because I'm going to be like, I have no idea what you're talking about.
You know, they got the order wrong, and I tell this to a lot of people. Yes, you know, past, present, future. I so think that it's so wrong. I think it's present, past, and future, due to the fact that because during your present time, you do something that ends up becoming your past. What in reality, if you go back and you face a lot of your past difficulties, predicts your future in the sense of actually puts you in a right. point to where, you know.
So much to say that whatever decision you make today will affect what happens tomorrow.
Yes. Because you have to live in the present in order for it to become your past.
Very much so.
Which then.
That is very intellectual. Look at you sounding all smart and stuff over here.
Yeah. I've been thinking about this since I was little, girl.
Y'all better catch the mega team.
Oh, but. So, you know, it was just a little brief introduction, and she's
20 minutes of us babbling on and on about nothing.
She's pretty much shy. I'm probably going to have to pull her teeth and tickle her fancy in order to get...
Yeah, don't tickle me too much.
to get her on here, but, you know, hopefully we can get a good start off, and we don't know exactly what day or how we're going to post, but this is a start.
This is a journey.
Yes. So don't get hooked on certain days just yet. When we get to that point, we'll make sure we explain.
First of all, we got to find some listeners, babe. This is the very first one.
Maybe we're going to get some listeners.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's hope. I think we're going to do good.
Mm-hmm.
I think we're going to do pretty good. We've got quite a few topics and things. Maybe we can include some of our morning prayers and mantras and...
Yeah.
Spiritual inspirations and affirmations.
Yeah, I think so.
We share a little bit of our intimate and daily walk.
Yeah. Well, with that being said, guys, we totally appreciate you taking the time, whomever listens, when you listen.
To listen to us.
Yeah, Babylon and talk about crazy stuff.
Heaven knows what.
Yeah. We'll definitely share the link to where you, if you would like to leave a message. Again, you can also, with this link, let us know topics outside of commenting on our page and letting us know what you would like to for us to talk about. Again, there's no subject off limits because me personally, I'm an open book and I love talking about anything and everything. And she does too. She's just kind of, she's a little... shy on it, but she'll be all right.
That's a matter of opinion, but okay.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Mm-hmm. Well, until next time, Mr. and Mrs. will check out and see you later.
Bye. Oh, shit. I mean, excuse me. My bad. Can't even press the stop button.